Thank you so much, Bona, for such a lovely presentation. It was really fast-paced and we really enjoyed all the content that you covered. I guess one of the things we want to know, you published your first paper in this field close to 20 years ago. How has the field of inquiry into stress in dogs changed in that time?
A lot, I think. One of the main changes is that at the beginning we were still discussing whether dogs had emotions and to what level. And we're now completely beyond that. It's really about trying to determine if they have the secondary self-evaluative emotions, whether they really have an idea of their self and how self-conscious they are. And that, I think, has really changed. So in the past, we tried to more or less get away from terms like emotions and how they feel, things like that. It was really a thing at that time. Nowadays, it's not. We more or less accept that animals have feelings.
That's great. Thank you.
And how about the ways that we're, as you mentioned, investigating stress? How has that shifted in time?
How has it shifted? Some of the parameters are still around. You still see a lot of studies using this cortisol parameter. So in that sense, I think in death, many things changed. So in the understanding of how the whole system worked, including things like the negative feedback and the epigenetic mechanisms, so we really understand how things that you experience during your life have an effect on the DNA molecule, and this methylation, acetylation, how it silences or activates certain parts of the DNA, how that translates into a receptor for the stress hormone, and how that on its turn has an effect, for example, on the brake on the HPA axis system. And I think in that depth, because we know now a lot about DNA and how it works, I think that really changes things.
Now, we had a lot of interest in the yawning study that you touched on. Could you maybe give us a little bit more information about that?
In a conclusion, as you understood. So the yawning has been related to things like conflict behavior. It has been linked to arousal, going to sleep, becoming awake. But nowadays, we also see that in response to social triggers, social stimuli, we also start yawning, dogs start yawning. And I think there is good evidence for that. So personally, I'm convinced that dogs are susceptible to contagious yawning. And that says something about how they perceive the people around them. If it really says something about their level of empathy, I don't know. But it, I think, at least demonstrates how they really are tuned in to humans, observe them, and respond to them. And I think this is really relevant in the context of this social referencing. And it's again a sign that dogs really pay attention to their owner and let their own emotions be regulated by that, how the owner responds, how it acts, its facial expressions, things like that.
And another social context that dogs are exposed to very often is the leash. So a lot of people talk about the leash being a factor in stress. Do you have any thoughts on that? How a leashed dog could be affected?
I find it a really difficult one. I could, of course, speculate on that, but I can't retrieve any hard experimental studies on that. And actually, I think this is one of these simple questions that we really need to put to the test. You can do relatively simple studies, and some of them have been done, I now remember. Is it really stressful? It will create a kind of conflict, I think, in the dogs, so you will see, at least in certain dogs, conflict behaviors. If it really leads to a strong negative state, I doubt it. In the beginning, of course, it could be. If it's new and they have to get accustomed to it, it will be stressful, but if they get used to it, to me it seems unlikely that it causes a real negative emotional state. But of course, I guess they're better off if they don't have it. They will appreciate not being leashed, probably.
We've got time for one last question. What do you wish the general dog-only public knew about stress in their dogs? What's the one thing, if you wanted to share one thing with the general public who own their dogs, that you'd like them all to know about stress?
I think it's important to understand that many of these stress signals is about conflict, so not necessarily about negative emotions, but it's about arousal. And I think it's important to be able to recognize them. And you saw this study of Marit, where they presented behaviors to the owners and asked them, okay, do you see this as one related to stress, or is it something more neutral? Very important stress behaviors were actually missed. Conflict behaviors were actually missed. I think that's pretty. So I think we could make owners more aware of how to read their dogs and to observe these stress signals.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much. We are going to break for lunch here in Phoenix, and we'll be returning in 90 minutes' time at 2 p.m. So please rejoin us then. Thank you very much, and thank you, Bonnie.
Thank you.